第十对演讲的题目是 Number 4, 计时开始。
Good morning to everyone here today. My name is Claudia. My teammate and I would like to speak to you about a wonderful opportunity we have been given. We have been asked to design a 3-day-long Taiwan Days Festival, which would take place overseas. The aim of the festival would be to promote and showcase Taiwan's uniqueness to the world. While this may sound like an easy task,We soon realized there was going to be a major issue to concern ourselves with. How could we possibly decide on what aspect to include when there are so many things that make our little island so special? The only way to plan properly would be to take our whole country with us. But sadly, this wouldn't be possible. So, after much thought,We have decided to focus on the aspect which we believe make Taiwan truly unique. Now, Janice will continue with some of our ideas.
Thank you, Claudia. There's no doubt that when people imagine a festival centered on Taiwan, they think of food. Taiwan's food, especially its delicious night market and roadside snacks,have become famous all over the world. Anyone attending our festival and not being able to experience our cuisine could be very disappointed. Therefore, we decided we would set up a night market style food trees with stalls on both sides and tables where guests could sit, chat, and eat. Of course, we couldn't possibly offer every snack because there are just too many.However, over a 3-day weekend, we could present a large variety of the tasty treats we are known for. And if our guests knew, there would be a whole new range of food to taste the following day. You can be sure we would see them on all 3 days. Yes, the specialty foods we have to offer must be included. Now Stephen will continue with our speech.
Thank you, Janice. Another thing that makes our country so special is the people. Everyone who has visited our island knows the friendliness of Taiwanese to visitors. What they may not know about are the different cultures that coexist in harmony on the island. There are sizable Hakka and Aboriginal minorities living here, and they will be an important part of our festival.Can you imagine the excitement of seeing Amish tribe dancing in their amazingly colorful tribal dress, or hearing the sounds of traditional Hakka hill songs that are sung as tea leaves are being collected on the farm? In our festival's arts and crafts area, people will also have a chance to try their hands at traditional handicrafts, such as bamboo weaving. Taking on something that you made yourselfwould be so much more meaningful than simply buying a souvenir, don't you think? Finally, Doris will now offer some concluding thoughts.
Thank you, Stephen. Something else that just has to be shared with our world is the beauty of our natural landscape. From the beautiful outlying island and the stunning East Coast to the rocky peak of Jade Mountain,Is there anywhere else on Earth where the landscape changes so dramatically in such a short distance? Going hand in hand with this natural beauty is the well-developed infrastructure in place in Taiwan for cycling and hiking. The question is, how will we convey this to our visitors? The answer, VR, virtual reality.Through this medium and interactive journey through the stunning scenery of Taiwan would become an unforgettable experience. Of course, this would also showcase another area in which Taiwan is a world leader, technology. What a fantastic festival it would be! And what a great chance for us to share our love with the world.
Thank you for your attention.
第九队演讲的题目是 Number Three， 计时开始。
Honorable judges and distinguished guests, the main contribution Taiwan is the main contribution Taiwan is.The main contribution Taiwan is. The main contribution Taiwan is. Has made to the global health is its health insurance systems. Taiwan launched the National Health Initiative by integrating several medical plans from existing insurance systems. The original insurance in Taiwan is for laborers.Farmers and government employees, which covers only half the population. Nowadays, this has been expanded to provide equal coverage to all people, regardless of sex, age, financial status, and employment status. Also, the government has adopted a wide range of measures to reduce health inequalities, which affects the which affects the as well as the unemployed.
Moreover, all foreigners who legally work or reside in Taiwan are also provided the same coverage. The National Health Insurance is a public program run by the government, which is based on a special model invented by brilliant experts in Taiwan.Life expectancy in Taiwan has subsequently increased to high level compared to other countries, with women living to 83 years old on average and men to 76. Surprisingly, healthcare costs are far lower in Taiwan than in most highly developed countries such as Europe and America, at $1,430 per capita. Over the last 20 years,Taiwan's healthcare has undergone several reforms to ensure its accessibility and practicality.
Taiwan's strengths in this area are greater than other countries. However, Taiwan is not allowed by the 70th WHA as an observer last year. By trial and error, Taiwan seeks to participate in the 71st WHA this year in a professional and pragmatic way.So as to realize the WHO's vision. In addition, Taiwan also focuses on the implementation of UN Sustainable Development Goal 3, whose concrete action is to strengthen public healthcare capabilities for chronic conditions, enhance care, build relevant data system, and produce epidemiological reports with statistical analysis, leading to good health and well-being.
In a globalized world, it is impossible for countries to overcome all their healthcare challenges by themselves. We can build a complete global health system that consistently meets the healthcare needs of the global citizen. Only through interdisciplinary and international organized cooperation, an endeavor to achieve the WHO's ultimate goal of health for all. Taiwan has a constructive role to play.In creating a concrete global health network. The best way to share our experience with other countries is through participation in the World Health Assemblies, as well as the WHO. Therefore, we urge that the WHO and the related international organization can acknowledge Taiwan's long-standing contribution to promoting human health around the world.And recognize the significance and legitimacy of Taiwan's involvement as an observer in the 71st WHA. We surely believe that Taiwan's healthcare system can serve as a model for other countries.
Thanks for your attention.
第八队演讲的题目是 Number One， 计时开始。
Diplomacy is the activity of communication between political entities. With Taiwan, geographically located at the crossroads of the Asia-Pacific region. Similar to Singapore, our diplomatic work must balance between the big powers, which all of the people on the island must face together. The international reality makes our fate uncertain, but we never give up. The emergence of the new southbound direction policy marks a new paradigm for diplomatic work to enter multilateral and regional integration. The indicators we use to measure diplomacy have also entered into an era in which culture, ideas, regional economic, and security communities are also as important as economic and military competition.
Thank you, Iris. Aside from communication between political entities, asking how can the conflicts between diplomacy be properly resolved is also an important aspect. For example, when the detention of a fishing boat occurs in our country, is it appropriate to use the transfer quota as a means of diplomatic countermeasure? It must rely on the extradition by the Ministry of Justice for International Judicial Cooperation. Both the Ministry of Health and Welfare, as well as the Ministry of Economic Affairs, must also assess the social impact of suspending foreign employment. The ministry has become necessary for the government, the ministry, and the private sector to cooperate.
That's right, Arthur. I feel that the current diplomatic work is more dependent on the cooperation between the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and other official units. For example, migrant workers and new residents bring the culture which originally belonged to Islam to Taiwan. When the fast of breaking the fast is celebrated in Taiwan, units which were not originally part of the diplomatic system, such as the police and local governments, are now play important roles in effective communication and mutual understanding between cultures. This also enhances Taiwan international relations. In addition to what we have covered, the work of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs can also be related to our daily life. Emily, what is the relationship between the diplomatic work and ordinary people?
I think it is a sense of convenience and coexistence. For example, our passport can enjoy visa-free and visa-on-arrival treatment in more than 160 countries. What does this treatment mean? It means that we are trustworthy and that the standard and quality of our people is held in high regard. It also welcomes us. I believe that we can have great exchanges and interactions with the locals of any country, which benefits both sides. Moreover, the people of Taiwan are known for their kindness and love. We are located in the Pacific Ocean, where typhoons and earthquakes are frequent. Taiwan's past natural disasters have provided a lot of valuable experience, from disaster relief to climate and hydrological prediction. Taiwan has many stories to share. Self-sufficiency is hard during these times. Luckily, many parties strive to help open the door to international relations with Taiwan by providing human care. With this, during natural disasters, we witness the spirit of human relationships and interdependence.
Thank you, Emily. Diplomacy has gone from past diplomatic dinner and heads of state to further deepen. It can almost be said that every citizen has the ability to convey goodwill and to participate in diplomatic work. With new media traversing the boundaries like time and space, and with the rise of the low-cost airline, going abroad and accessing foreign information are no longer as expensive or rare as one was. You never know who that person you met in the youth hostel will become in the future. No one can anticipate the impact of an amateur video posted online. Therefore, I believe that diplomatic work for young people of this generation is no longer just a visa or scholarship, but more often carries our dreams and hope for lives.
When we strive to take roots in various foreign countries,
understanding our differences
and pursue a consensus.
It changes the fate of the island.
Thank you.
Number 1, 计时开始.
Good morning, honorable judges. Diplomacy is to people's daily lives what a bridge is to communities. To connect Taiwan with the global community, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs serves as people's bridge to the world. A bridge that allows people in Taiwan and those in other countries to have mutual understanding of each other. A bridge that paves the way for potential lucrative industrial cooperation for Taiwanese corporates and our global partners. A bridge that leads Taiwanese people to explore the world with a safety net. The work of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs makes it possible for Taiwanese people to stay linked with the world in our daily lives. Now, we'll have Vicky further elaborate on how this diplomatic bridge works in enhancing people's cultural experiences of other countries.
Thank you, Patrick. No doubt, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs has put countless and continuous effort into building up a meeting point for people in Taiwan and those in other countries to promote cultural exchange on both sides. With a platform established by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Taiwan and the other countries are both invited to present their cultural heritage through all kinds of means, such as conventions, performances, exhibitions, and even sports events. Take 2018 Flora World Expo, for example. People in Taiwan will be presented with a chance to appreciate floral and gardening arts across the world, and also introduce our agricultural techniques to the world. At this cultural platform connected with diplomatic efforts, people will be provided with an opportunity for cultural sharing, learning, interaction, and thus acquire the experience and civilities to be a better global citizen. Besides serving as a bridge for cultural exchange, Stephen has more thoughts on how the Ministry of Foreign Affairs plays a part in promoting international collaboration.
Thank you, Vicky. Taiwanese people benefit more from positive economic cooperation with other countries, which is facilitated by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Our diplomatic officials have been working on strengthening and maintaining relations with Taiwanese corporates and foreign counterparts. By collecting information and analyzing local industrial development, arranging cross-nations conferences, and making introduction of Taiwan's industries and national economic development outlooks, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs acts as a bridge for people on both sides to bring what they can best offer to each other to form a mutually beneficial and profitable alliance, boosting economies side by side. Undeniably, diplomatic efforts make a difference in people's lives. What's more, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs is also an available and timely helping point for Taiwanese visitors to the world. Now, I'm going to invite Stephanie to share her opinion on this.
Thank you, Stephen. When traveling overseas, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs works as our Taiwanese helping point for all the necessary travel relief and emergency assistance. With over 100 consulates and embassies around the globe, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, our fellow men, would definitely be the first one we turn to for help. Whenever people travel for sightseeing or for business, some unexpected incidents, more often than not, are bound to happen. When that happens, we would expect our diplomatic officials to lend us a helping hand. On this bridge supported by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, we are provided with a comprehensive range of travel relief, such as required travel document application, travel emergency assistance, information of traveling country safety, and of course, familiar faces and warm welcome from home.
All these diplomatic efforts make it feasible and desirable for Taiwanese people to explore the world with a trustworthy backup behind.
In the end, when each one of us is trying to live out our lives as a global citizen, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs surely paves the way for us and build a solid bridge to lead us into the world and introduce the world to Taiwan.
A bridge for cultural learning exchange.
A bridge for economic and industrial cooperation.
A bridge for traveling assistance.
And a bridge for connecting Taiwan with the world.
Bao.
Thank you.
Number two, 计时开始.
Judges, teachers, and fellow students, good afternoon. The new sound policy has been around for a while, and it really left good impressions of Taiwan around the Southeast Asia countries. But here comes the question, what can we do to inform and educate people in those countries, and let them know not only about Taiwan, but also the future goal of the new sound policy? Are there any innovative ways that we can do to spread our ideas? In this ever-changing world of media and information exchange, we believe there are ways that we can reach the ears, minds, and hearts of our neighbors.
Hey, we believe that there are actual ways for us to utilize this technology and media to accomplish this goal. We nowadays live in a society surrounded by the internet and other forms of technology. We really should consider taking this advantage of the tools that we have. For example, YouTube and Instagram are social media platforms that many people use nowadays. If we use this media, if we post videos or even media on these daily use societies, we might be able to promote our policy's publicity through our videos and posts. We can open the eyes of those around us as to see what Taiwan is really like. With this new side of social response, with this new age of social media, it will be much easier for people to accomplish this goal, and this will allow Taiwan to leave good impressions on a good impression as a whole.
I think that video games is also a new media that we can take advantage of. Maybe we can try creating a video game in which timeline and background are set in modern days or recent Taiwan. We can showcase our technological advancement as well as medical advancement. Through the playing of the game, the players will be able to experience life in Taiwan and cooperate with neighboring nations. Perhaps even form online alliances to see how each other can benefit from participation. Through the virtual alliances, maybe we can plant seeds in this mind of youth to get out there and to form real ones and to benefit our sector of our globe. We can also include some of the goals of southbound policies so that the players can be more familiar about our world ideals and what we want to live on the society. So Austin, do you have any innovative ideas?
Of course I do. What if we utilize the latest technology, virtual reality, and use it as an experience type of media by programming places in Taiwan in VR? People can view our beautiful Taiwan right from the comforts of their homes. They can view our lovely sceneries, our tourist attractions, and this may light a fire right in their hearts and their minds. This should make getting to know Taiwan much easier for people in Southeast Asia. Once they immerse themselves in our culture, they will be more willing to come and experience all that we have to offer. They will also yearn to come and visit these places in real life, and thus boosting economy, tourism, and building actual physical relationships. As for the people from Taiwan, we can do the same for them, providing similar opportunities to learn more about Southeast Asia and giving them the experiences they need.
In conclusion, we are a new generation for this policy. How to use the new media to spread our ideas is definitely what we should be considering about. Sharing information in medias, introducing Taiwan environment in video games, or even using the latest technology, virtual reality, to let people know what life is like in Taiwan, are all great ways to get the outside world involved. All of the above are all ways that we can do to make the world get to know us better. Once again, we are a new generation for this policy. We should try new ways, do new things, and strive to make the world a better place. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day.
Number 4, 计时开始.
Come on, let's walk through the crowded streets of Shilin Night Market, climb the highest mountains of Nantou, relax on the sea-swept beaches of Kending, or soar through the skies in Taidong's hot air balloons. Taiwan has many appealing qualities that need to be experienced on this unique island in the Pacific. In order to familiarize the world with this unique, thriving, and hospitable culture, we must first distill the essence of what makes us Taiwan. Good morning, esteemed judges, honorable aspiring young diplomats, and exquisite members of the audience. Today, we stand before you to propose some of the featured events held here in the Taiwan Day at a foreign country. The ideas we will share with you capture some of the distinctive festivals held here in Taiwan, the daily habits of families, and exquisite cuisines that fill our mouths with joy. Jasmine, please let's start with an adventure on the city slope to model an iconic summer festival in Taiwan.
Thank you, Vincent. Our first feature event is the street version of the classic Dragon Boat Festival. In this upgraded version, we do away with those heavy wooden boats in favor of a rectangular-shaped box and four wheels, or, as it's known in America, a soapbox derby. This fun, child-friendly activities could really appeal to regions throughout the world as families work together to build their vehicles and race down the gentle city slopes. And while we're at it, why not expand on the car design by adding some oars or some extra seats to better fit the traditional Dragon Boat design? The derby starting line and ending line could also be an exhibit space for the traditional story of Chu Yuan, and offer holiday package in June for tourists to witness the festival on the banks of Lugan, Taipei, and Kaohsiung.
Thank you, Jasmine. Once patrons of the festivals have had their fun at the Sobuck Dragon Ball Derbies, why not stop by one of the tea stands to share in the special magic that is Taiwan's bubble milk tea? From the Instagrammable beauties that are brown sugar bubble milk tea to the classic taste of bubble milk black tea, these playful yet fun drinks are sure to bring customers back the next 2 days of the festival. Tea stands could also have a Taiwan giveaway for at-home recipes or even trips to Taiwan. You know what pairs best with the bubble milk tea, though? A walk through a traditional night market. Warren, why don't you walk us through the crowded street of our little pop-up night market?
With pleasure. My childhood was a mix of cram school and late-night night market games. Hugging those plush toy prizes almost made all the Saturday mornings worth it. I don't really think cram school is something people will want to share, but I'm sure they'll love the Fridays of our glorious night markets. Claw games, tile flipping, pyramid canes, sausage plinko, all the classics must be there. Merchandise showcasing popular cartoons seen throughout Taiwan, and Taiwan's Touch Your Heart apparel will be the hot item at this fun-filled event. And when the sun comes up on the second day of the festival, people will be ready to compete in the variety of sports tournaments, dressed in their new gear. From an indoor badminton tournament to Gai Tai Chi in the park, we'll feature on many of the favorite pastimes of countless Taiwanese. In mentioning pastime, the youngins might love to try a hand in table tennis matches against some robotics opponents. This will help showcase some of Taiwan's top talents in advanced programming and robotics, shining a light on Hsinchu's increasing relevance as an eastern Silicon Valley. Angela.
Thank you, Warren. Which then brings us to our final day of the festival. And what better way to start the morning than to host a temple parade and firecracker celebration?
Mazu, Guangdong, and Guanyin all have unique areas. As guests of the festival, are welcomed at a gate by Dallas Godley of the large region-specific lantern. It's constructed in the middle of the festival. Red paper lantern swings overhead in alleys between the festival tents. The end of the festival will end with a ceremony to ignite. Excuse me. To ignite a large central lantern and have a time for guests to send their own paper lantern into the sky with the message of hope for the future. Translator will be on hand to help guests to express their message in traditional Chinese, should they choose to do so.
By golly, I'm buzzing with the excitement over the thought of sharing some of these remarkable events with the world. I hope, along with my fellow diplomats, we'll all get that day sometime soon.
Thank you.
Number 5, 计时开始.
Ladies and gentlemen, judges, distinguished guests, a very good day to you. In the next 5 minutes or so, my teammates and I will be elaborating on how we can best enhance our relations with our southbound policy partners. For us, we have identified various strategies and issues which must work in together in order to make Taiwan attractive to our partner countries. We will be taking a closer look at our political trade, economic issue, tourism, and infrastructure to decide how all these matters must work in tandem. We believe the key here is to extend a vigorous economic and technical cooperation with our partner countries, work to enhance our friendly and cooperative culture, and thus contribute to the region's stabilization. Belinda.
Thank you. Relations between Taiwan and our partner countries have traditionally been complementary. By joining southbound partners, wealth of natural resources with Taiwan's industrial and technological strengths, our partner countries will hold increasingly strong expectations of cooperation with strong Taiwanese economy in promoting their own economic and social development. Our government contributing increasingly to the world economy. Therefore, trade with other countries will lead to the free trade agreements. These agreements are beneficial as they encourage inclusion and education of all our cultures. This improves communication, which naturally is a diplomatic benefit in itself.
Chrissy.
Thank you. The benefits of trade will be enormous. We can produce certain goods more efficiently. If we capitalize on this by trading, it will make our other countries better off. Because countries that are less efficiently were able to produce the product, can purchase it from other countries and focus only on comparative advantage. This lower average cost and then result in lower average prices. More exports, which means a higher level of economic growth due to more cash within economy. Putting all these factors together, trade is essentially the bedrock to enhance our relationship. Our government must provide a solid package of financial reforms, investment, and incentives to attract their talent, their leadership, and their success. By doing this, Taiwan will be firmly placed on the map in the world as a truly global business hub. Olivia.
Thank you, Chrissy. Business before pleasure, as the saying goes.
Taiwan isn't just a global business hub. Taiwan is steeped into traditional Chinese culture, with influences with Japan and the island's own indigenous tribes. This Formosa is a destination full of surprises. Beyond the bustling metropolises are lush tropical landscapes, rushing rivers, hot springs, and some of Northeast Asia's tallest mountains. The island is a compact showcase of natural attractions and cultural jewels, with unexpected marvels around every corner. We need to showcase Taiwan's uniqueness to all the hustle and bustle of business life, the tranquility and serenity of our forests, the crystal clear cool waters from our waterfalls, the endless array of food selections, and lastly, but certainly not least, our unrivaled service and hospitality must be promoted vigorously to our southbound friends. So, even if we don't do business together, we are still forever friends.
One, two.
Thank you!
One, two, three.
First of all, I would like to congratulate you, all of you, who have stood on the stage today, that you have completed a very difficult task. 6 years ago, I also stood on this stage, trying to share my observation about performances. And at that time, we still need to focus on like in sound, pronunciation, enunciation, all those English abilities. But this year, we noticed that I have actually no comments for your English ability. You have actually know how to use voice variation, use pause, and use emphasis to present. You express pretty well in English. And in the past, we probably need to talk about like structure, how to have a good opening, a nice ending. But again, I observed that this year, you use story to open your speech, or a question, or a personal experience. And those are all very good. So I could only say that the questions you have today are very difficult. We all judges agree with that. The questions are difficult, but you have done a great job. There's a few things I would like to share. First of all, since this is a speech, you will probably want to make it clear to your audience. So try to make the sentence short. Some of the group are still using clauses that is better for written language. But for oral, it will be better to make it clear when you talk to the audience. And the second one would be the strong focus. Since you want to make it clear, then the speech need to have a very strong focus that help us remember and try not to fill in all the information that you can find in the government website, fill in like advertising the policy, but try to focus on one thing. Since there are five different questions, and some of you will probably want to use information from other questions that you have prepared. But when you prepare the questions, try to decide one important keywords for each question. Then that will help you have a very strong focus for each question, and that will make your speech easier for the audience to remember, to impress. And the last Last thing that I would like to remind you is forgetting lies. Of course, see, I bring this to make me feel comfortable, and you don't have that. So one thing we can do about forgetting lies is that we don't try to memorize the lines. We remember the topic, the picture. If you are prefer remembering pictures, then try to remember pictures that you want to talk about or remember the topic so that it will be easier for you to pick up instead of trying to remembering the sentences. But I really need to say that you are actually doing very well. Some of you probably have forgot lines, but you have gracefully complete a task, complete your speech. So again, at the end, I would like to thank you or all of you who have completed this difficult task wonderfully and gracefully. And remember to thank all those who have supported you all along up so far. Enjoy this moment for your success. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. 我就用国语讲哈，因为我想说尽量的把我们今天看到的一些给大家参考。那你们还是可以衡量一下要不要接受我们的建议，因为其实有时候这种认为好或不好的表现其实非常主观。那就 English ability 而言的话，基本的像 pronunciation, intonation, fluency, 我觉得都是某个水准以上，那我就不就这个来讲。那我觉得比较困难，对你们而言比较困难的地方就是我们会期望你的这个 speech 是很自然的，可是因为你们是背的，所以你要把背的背到很自然其实是不容易的一件事。那可是你如果太明显的就是在死记的话，分数一定就会比较受影响。所以我想这个是提供同学参考，就是有时候比如说我觉得你很自然，你的 natural delivery, 你应该就不会时常的在强调每一个字，这样就你们有时候会 overdo it, 然后就真的该强调的时候就没有办法凸显出来。所以就是怎么样让你自然一点，然后该强调的时候你可以达到那样子的一种效果，它是 effective 的这样。那再来就是有时候你们会用到很难的字哦，那例如疾病或者是某种医疗器材，那这是一个说的 presentation, 所以有时候对观众而言我们会听不懂，所以你有没有办法让他没有这么丰富的医疗相关背景的人也能够听得懂，这就很重要。所以你可能就是加一点同义字或者是某种解释，就是尽量让我们所谓的凡人可以听得懂的那种医学的概念这样。所以在vocabulary 还有 word choice 这些可以参考。那 content 的部分呢，我觉得五个题目，然后你只有20分钟，再来可能再把它组合或怎样。所以对我们评审而言，我们时常可能就是要在思考的就是你到底有没有 to the point, 你选的题目跟你讲的内容到底它的那个契合度是怎样。所以我们一直都要看我们的 keywords, 你有没有把这些 keywords带进来。所以有时候就是会觉得好像是你套到的是别题的 keywords 这样。所以我觉得可能有没有切题这也是一个很重要的考虑。那当然对你们来讲就是很难啊，就是这么多题目如果你预先都要准备的话你也 很难说你全部都能够每个题目都很擅长，所以有时候也是运气问题。那在你的内容的时候呢，毕竟它是一个整体的那个 teamwork， 然后你们有四个人，所以你们在这四个人的内容的分配上可能还是要考虑它是要有一种结构性的，就是如果我们以写作的概念来看的话，你的 introduction 你要怎么样带到一些重点，然后让下面的也许两位或三位同学再去发展，或者是去 support 你们的这一个观点，然后最后当然你要有一个 wrap up， 有一个 conclusion， 它不用很长，但是要有。然后内容的话，当然就是你的内容，它到底吸不吸引我？就也就是说，你的听众会不会很有兴趣听？所以你的内容的话，就是也许是有趣也可以，也许是很有见解。那很长时候你们可能就是搜寻网站，然后一些数据，那些东西当然很好，可是就是每个人都可以找得到的东西，然后它就没有什么太有类似就是你对一个问题的那种自己的想法的那种关注，就没有办法表现。所以我想可能有时候我们会听到的内容其实都大同小异这样，那就你就没有办法凸显，就没有那个特色出来。所以我想可能在内容上你们还可以朝向你对这样子的题目你个人有什么样子的观感这样，就你个人的那种想法会多一点的话，它可能会更有一个特色。那最后就是 stage manner， 其实 stage manner 我们裁判在还没开始之前就已经对这一点做了一些意见的交换。那我想这个它可以很广，它也可以很精确的讲，比如说 stage presence， 但是我们当然也尽量的把你们在四个人的比如说转换，就转换那个 speaker 的时候的某些默契也尽量的考虑进来，只是有时候在台上你们紧张的时候你做的比如说 eye contact， 我觉得就有时候不是很到位哦，就你要介绍另外一个 speaker， 你讲了他的名字可是你却没有看他，这样的话就是感觉上好像就是那个 format 有了，但是呢就是没有 acknowledgement 的那种感觉。还有讲话的时候会有一些肢体动作，当然我们也是一样，就是你要让我觉得很自然会最好，就是最上层的就是你effortless 这样，但是这个毕竟是开玩笑了，就是怎么可能 effortless， 我们就是 make effort 嘛， right？ 但是你又要让人家觉得你是没有那样子的做作，所以不太容易。那有时候你们肢体动作太多的时候，其实就像是intonation 的概念一样，你如果太 dramatic 的时候反而你就没有效果了，因为所有东西都没有办法区分它的那个重点这样。所以我想这个肢体动作要有，可是不要做太多。然后要不要走来走去，我觉得这也是一个见仁见智的问题，就是走来走去 passing 其实是要让人家觉得你很自在。所以我想那样子的自在的感觉比较是重点，而不是一定要走来走去。那你如果不走来走去，你站着你也是很自在，其实也很好，只是说站着你又怕让人家觉得很僵硬，所以真的是很困难。我也觉得我希望我不要让你们觉得我不知道要讲什么，但是就是你要对你自己的肢体是很自在的这样。那你需不需要走动，我觉得不见得。那忘词哦，其实忘词的话你不一定要一字不漏的把你原来背的东西或者是原来准备的稿子一定要每个字都讲，不需要，因为 一紧张之后，你怎么想还是想不起来吗？那可是你不能一直就是站着，那你还是要想办法讲。所以你就是换，你可以用理解的方式，你要讲的内容是什么，换个方式讲，很口语也都没有问题哦。那所以我想，有时候就是这样子的一种临场表现，它会更重要，而不是说我一定只能照我原来规划的。太多事情是我无法规划的，所以我们就变成你遇到什么状况，你就临场去解决这个问题。那我想这个是就这三部分我们的一些看法给大家参考。那恭喜各位同学，也感谢指导老师很辛苦哈。那谢谢各位。
各位同学、各位师长、各位家长，大家午安，大家好。好，那个我先自我介绍，我是国教署高中职辅导陈东营陈科长。那今天非常高兴到这个场地来颁发我们中区的这个算初赛哈，外交小见面初赛哈。那我刚刚会前呢有跟我们在这里哈，我想先我们新民高中的同学在哪边？新民高中哦，在后面哈。我们要特别谢谢新民高中的师长还有同学给我们这么好的场地，给自己掌声鼓励一下。那第二个呢，我们要谢谢今天帮我们办理这个活动非常重要的公共电视的殷小姐。那第三个呢，我们要谢谢我们外交部跟我们教育部一起合办的林小姐。看一下，哦，抱歉，是吴小姐，不好意思哈。好，那我们这个先恭喜在座的这所有的学校哈，我们这17所学校，也就是17队哈，那经过昨天的比赛呢，脱颖而出。那后续呢，在这个11月初哈，还要再办理这个决赛啊，全国决赛。那我们下周跟下下周是北区跟南区的这个初赛，那。先在这边先恭喜各位同学，也鼓励各位同学呢，这个有不论今天的结果如何啦，有优良的，那也有进入到这个决赛的，我想同学在这边准备都非常的认真跟非常努力，那评审老师也看到各位的这个杰出的表现。那未来呢，我想都是台湾在担任这个不论是对外的交流工作，或者有兴趣的话，都可以呢成为这个台湾的未来外交的这个最好的助力了哈。那我想恭喜同学，也谢谢师长们对同学的指导哈。那未来我们台湾这个院长有赖院长有宣示啊，台湾未来在双语的推动、英语的推动上面会有很多的着力。那我想各位都是先驱啊，也是我们的这个种子哈，都是我们的种子。那希望未来呢，在这个双语教育部分呢，我们这个署里面的相关的政策会继续来推动。那也鼓励呢各校哈。各校回去多多鼓励小朋友来参赛，我觉得这是非常重要的活动。那我想今天呢，我们就先谢谢各位师长的参与跟各位同学参与。那接下来这最重要的，我们要来颁发2017年度外交小学兵中区比赛优良名单。序号一，台中市弘文高级中学，这没有欢呼啊，给自己欢呼一下。序号二，台中市威格高级中学，这样好了，那个是不是那个欢呼的时候大家举手欢呼一下，大家才看得到，我们摄影大哥才可以看得到。序号四，台中市味道高级中学 ，OK。序号九，新竹市曙光女子高级中学。需要21，东海大学附属高级中学，恭喜啊，恭喜！需要22，国立斗六高级中学，需要24，云林县正兴高级中学，需要26。台中市惠文高级中学，序号28，台中市智用高级中学， 7号30，台中市明道高级中学。好，以上恭喜这十队哈，表现优良学校哈。接下来的重头戏，我们还有这个六队哈，进入到我们决赛的学校哈。那现在开始公布哈，2017年度外交小尖兵中区比赛的优胜名单哈，有六队学校，序号7，台中市华盛顿高级中学。恭喜。第二队序号8，台中市明德高级中学。恭喜恭喜。好，第三队序号10，台中市新民高级中学。好，非常嗨哈，非常恭喜非常恭喜。第四队序号16，台中市小明女子高级中学。第五队序号29，台中市立仁高级中学。第六队序号31，彰化县金城高级中学。OK， 以上。总共我们有六队的入决赛学校，那还有10队的这个表现学校，非常恭喜，好，非常恭喜。